girls. Hush, hush, to ashes. Lust to dust. Deodorant death to the idolized bust. Hot goes the lolly. Hot goes the hair. Tonight we are mourning. Our music is dead. Now it's good morning, sunshine. Time to wake up and bow. High spirits and light hearts. No more private parts. Can you hear me? As you hear, here, and now.
Thank you. Thank you. bonne nuit. Au revoir. Buona notte. Muchas gracias. Adiós.
This is not Radio 4. This is Radio Gnome. Direct transmission from the planet Gong.
Bonsoir. Bonsoir. Planet Gong. Gnome. Direct. De la. Gong.
David, the group Gong became very well known for its Gong mythology, the planet Gong and pothead pixies and so on. How did you first originate that idea?
The band first started, it was called after Planet Gong, after I had met these beings from outer space who descended in a flying craft, which I have playfully called a flying teapot, because it seems, why not, you know, why not keep it playful? Who's going to believe? I mean, 90% of people, if you say some people have just come down from another planet and landed outside your door and you've had a cup of tea with them in a wrap, they would never believe you. So what's the point in saying, being serious about it? So therefore, a flying teapot came out outside my house one day, and these little green men with pointed heads came out, and they said, "Bonsoir," which is French for happy breakfast to you, you see? And I had a wrap with them, and they told me what to do. They said, "Well, man, get this band together and get it on the road, and then we'll tell you what to do next." And they did, and that's what happened. That's the story of the Gong. But who's going to believe me? Nobody. Well, you see, the Planet Gong mythology was an essential part of the whole Gong mystique. We were not a band that lived in a community. We all lived in bungalows, which were originally built for bank managers in Worthing. And mostly, we washed our hands in bowler hats because the houses were... We used black soap, which we could only get from Germany at great expense. You know, very difficult to find this black soap. You have to send away to Bulgaria. But most of the time, we never saw each other. We only came together for gigs. And then we mostly wore blinkers, obtained at great expense from outback Australian goose farms. The goose, as you understand, they always have special kind of multicoloured, you might say even psychedelic blinkers, stopping them from pecking each other to pieces. And that's the reason why we had them as well, to stop each other from pecking each other to pieces. Get that on daily travels, man. See what he says to that?
A slim chance.
Well, there's one show on radio that I really never listen to. It's Dave Lee Travis, you know? That guy's voice.
About about the gong myth, haven't you? They were quite well attended, weren't they?
Because basically they were lecherous lechers. And I think people come because it's a kind of poetic porn. No, that's ridiculous, isn't it? Basically what they are, they're just communication trips. They're just people who all come into a room and I tell the story of the planet Gong, amongst other things, and we talk about various things. We do all kinds of things. I played my new record, for example, at the last one.
You recorded the new album in Mallorca, didn't you? I believe you went back there to live, having left the group Gong.
Oh, well, when I left Gong, I went to Spain and started my own little studio there, which is to say, it's extremely primitive. I mean, a four-track Tiak tape recorder, and all the least expensive material, really. But it's a fantastic place, and Robert Graves chose this place to live because it has a lot of natural energy, a difficult thing to explain. But creative people, when they go there, they become very excitedly creative. And crazy people, when they go there, become very excitedly crazy. And depressed people, when they go there, get completely manically depressed. And so on. It's a place where everything intensifies. And my little studio, which is called the Banana Moon Observatory, because I spend so much time observing the moon when it's in the phase of the banana, which is to say the phase of the first quarter, is right in the midst of this large semicircular valley. It's a bit like living in the middle of an enormous natural electromagnet. The forces are intense. Even the colors are stronger there. So, of course, my intention was to make my music in this setting so that the energy would be included in the music, and when you listen to the music, these landscapes could reform behind your closed eyes or in your head or in your imagination.
Wasn't there recently an occasion in Paris where all the original members of Gong got together to play for old time's sake?
Yeah, this was a fantastic occasion because it was brought about, in fact, by sort of Gong freaks in France and by the guy who first signed Gong to a record company, which was Jean Caracos, who had big records to start with and later became Tapioca. Yeah, he financed this thing and he flew all the musicians from the actual Gong itself, but also he flew all the musicians in the groups that have been formed by the ex-members of Gong in, so that not only was the Gong playing, but all the groups of the ex-members of Gong were playing as well. This meant that there was a concert which started 2 o'clock in the afternoon and the show finished at 2 o'clock at night. It was 12 hours of the Gong family. People have spoken a lot about the Soft Machine family, made big charts about the Soft Machine family. And here was the Gong family, unbelievable collection of music. It was a great day, it was some really fine music played. And the climax of it all was, of course, us playing a selection of music from the Gong. Well, we started from Camembert Electric, played excerpts from Camembert Electric, and then we moved on to the trilogy, Radio Gnome, Angel's Egg, and You. And the curious thing was that though we haven't played this music for 2 years, we played it better than ever before, I seem to think. It may be the fact that we've all got better musically, we're better musicians than we were at that point. Also, it was the distance. We'd got a distance from each other, and we really appreciated each other as musicians. And that vibe really made for a good concert.
Was it recorded at all?
Yeah, it was recorded by Castro Cornflakes, according to him, by Tapioca chap, you know. And he has this vision of bringing it out. But unfortunately, there's a conflict between him and Virgin Records, who don't want him to bring it out and have stopped him from bringing it out. Or they've been a bit naughty to Virgin, let's face it. Mr. Brainstorm, Richard, my dear chum, naughty, naughty. Because on the, you know, on this Virgin compilation, which is a nice piece of work too, there's some great stuff on that. But, you know, on the inside of the cover, they've actually got some photos from the Hippodrome, which is naughty because I hope that nobody buys the Gong Live Virgin album thinking that there's music from the Hippodrome on, because there really isn't. The Hippodrome concert is being brought out by the French company Tapioca, and eventually we hope when the legal problems are sorted out, it will come through.
I must admit I'd expected something a little more poetry-based on the latest album, having confined yourself to fairly simple songs on Good Morning. Are you planning any future poetry work?
Yeah, people are pretty frightened of poetry.
Fossils measure only 2.5 thousandth of a millimeter in diameter. They were found in sedimentary rocks from the region of Barberton, about 160 miles east of Pretoria.
We end the program this week, as we began it, with a poem. This one's by the Australian rock musician and lyric writer David Allen, founder of the band Gong. And it comes on a new album, which will be released next month, called Now is the Happiest Time of Your Life. David Allen produced the record at his own studios in Mallorca, where he's lived since Gong broke up. Clive Williamson asked him to set the scene.
When I left Gong, I went to Spain and started my own little studio there, which is to say, it's extremely primitive. But it's a fantastic place because it has a lot of natural energy, a difficult thing to explain. But creative people, when they go there, they become very excitedly creative. And depressed people, when they go there, get completely manically depressed. And so on. It's a place where everything intensifies. And my little studio, which is called the Banana Moon Observatory, because I spend so much time observing the moon when it's in the phase of the banana, which is to say the phase of the first quarter, is right in the midst of this large semicircular valley. It's a bit like living in the middle of an enormous natural electromagnet. The forces are intense. Even the colors are stronger there. So, of course, my intention was to make my music in this setting so that the energy would be included in the music, and when you listen to music, these landscapes could reform behind your closed eyes or in your head or in your imagination. Actually, on the new album, I've got a kind of a nonsense crocodile poem, which was recorded in the Dea Poetry night, you know. Dea is the place where I live in Mallorca. Because every year we have Robert Graves lives there, and on his land there is a little amphitheatre, like a Greek amphitheatre, having written the Greek myths and all that sort of thing. And every year we have a poetry reading there, all the resident English, French, Spanish poets that are in town in the middle of summer. And usually about sunset we gather there and we have poetry reading. Well, this year we did it, and in fact on my record is one of the poems I read at that place, at the poetry. It's a very magical, beautiful place.
Belly full of telephone, cap full of telly, cool damn heels, hot damn feels, fool that phone, carve that stone, knock that rock, it's a click clack clock, it's a time to be knock knock, who's who, you two, anybody there? Knick knack, paddy whack, to keep a dog, to break the back, you're cool, I'm cool, everybody's so cool, you're cool, I'm cool, everybody's so cool. Bye bye, bye bye, side by flow, flum, twiddle flum, toe rag, fashion mag, who's the funny one with the belly laugh, kneecap, what's that, alligator, radiator, menthol, benzol, dingbat, pussycat, bum, no, belly gut, deep throat, berry bone, new star, crocodile, big deal, jelly bone, who's stone? Okay, now then, paper rapers, hop shop, capers, chanters, ranters, planters, banters, sausages and mash, have another bash, gosh! Sperm whale, brown ale, say when I'm going back to come again, now and then. You're cool, I'm cool, everybody's so cool.